Dissociation, this is our topic today. Welcome to the Matrixa with Jonathan and Shiva. Yes, we are here in the city called Battle, in the Battle Abbey. And we are in an underground, very tall building right now, I would say. And here the monks met. To philosophize. And only here they were allowed to speak. Outside the monastery, there was always the duty of confidentiality. And that's exactly what we want to do now. We will walk through the corridors and philosophize. Okay, with us there are perhaps more facts and exercises about dissociation. I agree. So, we talk a little bit about dissociation again. If you don't know our video about dissociation yet, you can at the end of this video also look at this. But for a more detailed explanation, we also make this video again here. I agree, we may go a little bit deeper and what possibilities you saw in your dream recently. Yes, I agree, then we also come to many interesting aspects of dissociation that are actually hardly known, if at all. And yes, we have been researching dissociation for a long time. I know it for over 20 years. And of course, a lot has been shown to me. And for me, dissociation is still the best and most effective technique out there. And also the most dangerous. At least not the most meek. Yes, the dissociation is a bit unpredictable. That's why not everyone should dare to do it. Because the dissociation can also trigger shock-like experiences. Can also be irritating at times. Shocking insights, sudden changes in reality. Sudden changes in personality that can come up so quickly that you hardly notice, and you have to have a lot of trust in your higher self. Yeah, for that somehow there has to be a connection already. Whoever stumbles and starts to doubt himself or to doubt his higher self can land on this S like I did 15 years ago. You can land on the S, I agree. And then, like to put spirituality aside for a while when you have no idea what is happening. And therefore, listen carefully, and then we give the best tips and tricks. So, accompany us through the park and through the nice underground walls of Battle Abbey in England. Yeah, our topic today is dissociation. We also did a lot of research on the internet and looked at what you could find. But nothing can be found about the real technique of dissociation, neither on the German nor the English-speaking market, except in the field of psychology, where this is declared as personality disorder. And yes, we find that a very exciting topic and research on it. And would like to take this a little closer to you today. Jonathan has already written a lot of articles about this on his blog matrixblogger.com. But we want to do that again as a video and bring our experiences a little closer to you. The goal of dissociation is to reach the so-called observer. Because the observer is the one who sees the world as it actually really is, and not as it was instilled into us from childhood with the help of innumerable associations. The observer is beyond all prejudices and expectations. You can answer your personal questions from the observer. And the people who are present also read as if they were a book out of glass. One can look to the bottom of their minds and recognize every problem and every intention. You can start laughing without reason, because you suddenly realize that everyone around us plays a role that is pretense. A mother thinks she's a mother, or a conductor, and so on. You can see the roles at the moment that every person plays every day, because you recognize an actor behind the role. Whoever has come too far is mostly ready for the next step. Now, let's take the steps closer to you that we did on the way into the dissociation. The dissociation can be divided into several steps that you go through until you really enter the true state of dissociation. I just describe how I do it or how we do it to take these steps. Yes, so in the beginning, in the first stage of dissociation, you notice a slight slowdown. You become trance-like fast. The head gets a little tired and heavy, thoughts slow down a bit. And you just don't have any more interest to think. And yes, it just slows down. The eyes slow down, the cycle of thinking slows down. And you can see that everything has slowed down. And you feel a little trance-like. I'm not saying a real trance, but trance-like. Then you have reached the first stage. You also have the feeling that the frequency in your head has changed, and that is exactly the point. It has changed. In the second step, when you have achieved that, you feel an easy step back. That means you distance yourself from reality. And yeah, you are no longer really with yourself, you could say.
Ja, man ist nicht mehr ganz bei sich selbst, könnte man so sagen.
And there you have the feeling that the frequency in your head has changed a bit. In the first step, you perceive that you really get clear in the front of your head. You get really clear and everything goes in the back of your mind. You also have a slight pressure in the back of your head. Yeah, I do not know how I could better describe it. But, as I said, the head is suddenly divided into two sections. At the front, everything is clear and bright, and at the back, it is slightly dull and with a slight pressure. In the fourth step, when you've come this far, then you feel a vibration inside your whole body, a slight vibration. How could you describe that? Not like an electric shock, but a slight tremor from the inside. Then that is the energy. Everything starts to vibrate. Energy is collected, and yeah, that's the fourth step. In the fifth step, you have the feeling, yeah, you could still think, but not really. So gradually it becomes less and less that you have the feeling that you can think. So somehow thinking starts to freeze more and more. At first you think, what could I think now? Then you have the feeling that somehow I can't think anymore. But I want to think now, but I can't think anymore. And yeah, that's how you start gradually with the cessation of thought. The next step shows a slight sense of freed. It's kind of an undetermined freed. It's kind of a little creepy, but not creepy like in a horror movie or in the horror strip, but it is such a somber mood. Which, yeah, as I said, feels slightly freedening. And then in the next step, there is also inner unrest. You have the feeling that your legs want to move or something wants to fidget. And you can tell that the energy is increasing because it really wants to be poured out through the limbs again. But somehow you should avoid that. In the next step, small shock moments may appear.
Schockmomente auftauchen.
And then
und
there are
da
the small
dann auch die
insights.
Einsichten und Erkenntnisse.
Sudden perceptions or completely different interpretation of a very specific situation. Yeah, these are
ja,
the eight
die acht
steps
Schritte,
that lead to the dissociation.
Ja,
yeah, with dissociation you have to imagine that every day
dass man ja tagtäglich,
it is thought, we think around 60,000 thoughts. We are not now aware of all 60,000 thoughts that are being thought. But there are already a few thousand thoughts that go through your mind so consciously every day. And all of these thoughts are electromagnetically charged, you could say. And these in turn feed on the energy that is available to us every day. It is believed that approximately 60 to 80% of the energy we have is available every day for thinking. So you can imagine what happens to this energy when you suddenly begin to dissociate. This means that this 60 to 80% of energy is suddenly stowed, like a dam, because you refuse to think. And if you refuse to think, this energy flows also arises. And that energy can then be used for something other are used. For example, to get into altered or high state of consciousness. Exactly, and it's not like that now either, that you have to reach all eight levels first to gain great insights. It is enough if you take a few minutes every day and limit your thinking. It has always brought me some smaller insights. So of course, the goal is to achieve complete dissociation for the great insights. But for small insight, it is enough to sometimes just take a little back
den Gedankenapparat zu verlangen.
And slow the mind down.
Ja, dann gibt's noch natürlich einen Unterschied zwischen
Dissociation. Yeah, then of course there is a difference between dissociation with eyes open and eyes closed. You can do both.
Ich bevorzuge eigentlich die Dissociation mit Augen auf.
I actually prefer dissociation with my eyes open.
Wirklich um die Erkenntnisse.
Since it's really about the knowledge and about increased states
ja,
of consciousness.
Erhöhte Bewusstseinszustände und man kann eben allerdings auch mit Augen.
And you can also dissociate with your eyes.
Und das ist allerdings immer noch nicht mit einer Meditation.
And that is still not to be compared to meditation.
Bei mir tauchen bei der
I see in a dissociation with my eyes closed
remote viewing Zustände auf oder klare
greater remote viewing states or clear HD images.
So wie man es auch
just like you may know it's from lucid dreams. Such clear images then appear, or situations, people, aliens, or no idea from where. Images just appear. This is the difference from dissociation with eyes closed and open. You shouldn't confuse meditation with dissociation. Meditation is about closing your eyes, getting calm. So it can be confused with dissociation a bit. But we are talking about very different frequency range that are active on it. In meditation, as I said, you go inside and try to achieve a certain calm, a glide with the river and so on. And you already allow associations to come into your mind. With dissociation, on the other hand, you can do it with your eyes closed. You can use it in any situation, for example, whatever shopping, driving, a bus and like. And the dissociation is really one completely different condition in which you really reach a moment when you are unable to think. The goal of the dissociation is actually to achieve a very specific feeling.
Ein ganz bestimmtes Gefühl zu erreichen.
To really feel
es
it. And you can activate that feeling within seconds.
Kann man innerhalb von Sekunden aktivieren,
If you have exceeded the status of a beginner, that means once you've trained yourself well enough, just sit down and enter a fully dissociated state within 3 seconds. But you have to get there first, and you can only do that by following these 8 steps first. Oh yes, these 8 little steps Shiva explained earlier, gradually achieved. And only after these 8 steps it is possible to get to know the special feeling. Because you don't know the feeling, and it's hard to create a feeling that you don't even know at all. And so it's very important that you learn through these 8 steps. To feel this feeling at some point, what it's like to be dissociated. And once you've got it, then you can reach the state within seconds in the future. Exactly, I had that last seen in hypnagogic states. That meditation and dissociation completely are different, completely different things. The dissociation is not a trance-like piece at all. So you can't compare it to a trance or a meditation at all. It's completely different states and you can't describe it at all. If you haven't experienced it, I think, so the feeling of dissociation is completely different from trance or meditation. And yeah, I also saw that you can switch directly into the dissociation. And maybe I just describe what I saw in a hypnagogic state. And I saw myself there in my other self. So my left self, so to speak, we also made a video about that, about the analog and the digital self. And then I saw that we are practically in 2 separate tunnels. But these tunnels are telepathically, through what I suspect, connected. So me with my other self, we are directly connected. And this other self that dissociates, practically dissociates all the time for me, so to speak. It is always in an increased state of consciousness. And if I wanted to, I could. Or if I wanted to, I could go straight to the state, because this is always available. One could also call up at any time all the information that had already been obtained through the dissociation by other self. If you can do it, of course, this is not an easy thing. That is, I'm just saying what I do experiences and have seen. And in this state of complete dissociation, you are actually completely in the other self, in this digital self, and can practically call up all information and just switch directly to the state where you can totally dissociate. As Jonathan said, within 3 seconds. Zap, you're in. And yeah, but you have to experience that first. The feeling of complete dissociation. It is not easy to achieve that. That's why I would suggest the steps, the 8 steps up there have already been written, just to practice step by step again and again. Always in the first state, then the second, the third, until you get into the vibration. And then try to vibrate directly. So don't go through all in one, but each other, because that won't work. But if you have a state after others, you get in there faster and deeper. One shouldn't believe now that the dissociation is an ongoing state. Dissociation is only a temporary state of not being able to think. This means that it's only a question of achieving a state through a dissociation by accumulating all the energy. For example, if you can think a word for a minute, and also do not use your imagination, for example, the pictured ideas, then you would already accumulate a lot of energy that brings us into an altered state of consciousness. A minute without thinking, without pictures in your head, pure emptiness in the head would create such an effect. And for that reason, when trying to dissociate, first try to do 1 minute. That means if you haven't thought for 20 seconds and suddenly you start thinking about something, oh, the cat is scratching on the door, or oh, the doorbell rang, or oh, I still have to shop, then you have to start all over again. The minute must be completed in one piece. You can also put a stopwatch next to it or the like if you want. So whatever you want to do, it's up to you. Anyway, the goal is 1 minute, not to think. And that can have quite some effects, evoke like little insights. Or that you have perceptions through the pineal gland. The pineal gland can also react if you don't think for a minute. You may be able to hear things or suddenly see things differently than you saw them before. So there can be an incredible number of effects. Therefore, first try to dissociate for a minute. And if you only think a word or have an image in your head within that 1 minute, what you might want to do or have planned for this or the next day, then start all over again until you have reached 1 minute. And then we come to the camouflage of the mind that can occur during the dissociation. The first thing that occurs to me is constantly someone sings in my head. So, earwigs, if you dissociate, yes, suddenly they're quite a lot. You have to ignore them. Yeah, so another camouflage would be, for example, that you get tired quickly. Or that you get really, really quickly distracted. Or you suddenly find yourself thinking about something else. Or that you suddenly start to think and you don't really notice that you're thinking about something. And at some point you say, shit, actually I wanted to dissociate, go for it. So you practically forgot that you just wanted to dissociate. What I often noticed earlier is that suddenly some things happen in the matrix. The cat jumps on the table, the phone rings, dogs barks, children come storming in or screaming around, or many, many small distractions that suddenly appear. They weren't there before. But if you want to start dissociating, suddenly they are all there. Or what is another camouflage? Oh! I'm dissociating right away, but I still have to do some washing up. That's really important. Or, oh, look again quickly on the cell phone so that everything is really done on the cell phone. Then I dissociate. Or, as I said, just that the mind says, come on, in 5 minutes or in 10. But then, definitely, in 10 minutes after, something else in 5 minutes. This is definitely a camouflage of the ego. So don't get fooled. One then tends to train the dissociation at another time, and the next time again another time. What is also common is that you suddenly become paranoid if you feel persecuted, or something is there, or something is strange. And what's the biggest camouflage for me is to feel fear in it. Something is about to happen. Maybe something bad. That feeling fear in it is such a slight feeling of fear. But I think when you get there that you are on a really good path to achieve the state of dissociation. Because once you get this fear and this feeling of freedom, then you're not very far from your left self. And that really likes to be camouflaged. Because that's a lot smarter and wiser than we are. And that the ego is afraid of the left digital elevated self. Somehow that should be clear to everyone, because the ego likes to feel threatened by something that could, so to speak, destroy it.
Das wären so die Tarnung, die
Yeah, that would be the camouflage of the ego that may came up spontaneously. Yeah, feeling paranoid. So these are the camouflages of the mind that can appear during the dissociation. Anyone who has trained it has been able to observe this so far, that one or more camouflages can occur.
Und bei manchen sogar alle, genau.
And for some, all of them. For me, for example.
Und, ja, was gibt es denn so für
And yeah, what kind of tricks are there to get into the states of dissociation in the first place? Shiva, what are the tricks to achieve the dissociation? Yeah, so my little tricks to get into the state of dissociation. Yeah, that would be, for example, saying stop to every thought that comes in. So, when you start to dissociate and then a thought comes to your head, say stop immediately. Sure, you'll start all over again and maybe that's tiring and exhausting because you might have to do this for 2, 3, 4 weeks again and again. Stop, 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 say stop. But at some point it has an effect and at some point the stop will also make you think less or that you then won't think any longer. At first it will be maybe 2 or 3 seconds where you can't think. Then it will be 10 seconds, then 30, 40 seconds. And after a month, or I don't know, it was 3 or 4 weeks for me, then it really stopped thinking, so that I couldn't think any longer. So say stop has a very good effect, as I said. Yeah, as I said, against the one who constantly signs in the head helps the same thing. You have to say stop and constantly say stop. I agree. Then, as I said earlier, don't try to take all 8 steps at once, but to practice step by step. First, the first again and again, come into the first state. Then into the second state. Every state has a certain feeling, and you have to remember this feeling, save that, and then try to get that feeling into that state. And then try to get the second state, and then the feeling that everything is dull in the back and clear in the front. And at some point you can also make it that you can switch directly to the third state, or directly into the fourth, where everything starts to vibrate. You can even learn that relative quickly, in 1-2 weeks. I agree. And the next tip would be, if you find yourself thinking about something that seems totally important, and then you say to yourself with that greatest understanding and compassion, yes, I know that's totally important now and you want to think about it. And I totally understand it, but come on, hey, there's still 10 minutes left. Now, let's be quiet for a while and practice a little dissociation and then we'll think about it in detail. And yeah, mostly understand that the aspects in your head too. And then actually give peace, at least that's how it works for me. The next step would be imagine 100 small dots in front of your eyes and jump randomly from one point to another. So you take 3 to 5 points per seconds. It's like looking for something. This is the first state I described at the very top. That you slow down. I do it like this. If I can't imagine 100 dots, then I jump with my eyes. No idea. Now I see TV. The left corner on the TV. The plate. The jacket. The couch. The chair. The washing machine. And so I just jump back and forth with my eyes so that you get these 100 points and jump, 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 jump. And at some point you get slower and tired and you come easily into a very light trance. But this is not to be confused. You don't really get into a trance because dissociation and trance are different things. You just slow down. That would be the first stage. Just get slower. And you can achieve this by these points, which you keep trying to fix on. And the next hint would be that you can do dissociation anywhere. That means you don't have to be calm and quiet. And that's not the goal at all. The goal of dissociation is to be able to do it anywhere. in the subway, while shopping, going for a walk, in the bus, in the cafe, and no matter what noise is around you, whatever is going on around you, you can use it anytime, anywhere. You just shouldn't be distracted. And it is imperative to follow what's going on out there now. Follow the sound now or the woman who dropped the shopping bag. You just notice it. And concentrate and just focus on what you're doing. Dissociation. So, what I always do as a trick is, I blink my thoughts away. I always think that's great, that's right, it also works. As soon as I think, blink, and now that the thought disappears. That's why I blink a lot sometimes. I can't happen that I blink around. At that moment, I try to blink away my thoughts, so that I always help me a lot. Yeah, and of course, the stop exercise is great, and that helps quite well. And yeah, what possibilities are there that can be achieved through this superpower of dissociation? And if you use the dissociation constructively, you don't feel like a victim of disability. Because there are people who suddenly encounter dissociation without knowing what is happening to them and don't even know what's going on. Yeah, as me for example, yeah, and then of course you get scared or worried or would like to get rid of that. And some even run to a psychologist or a psychiatrist and say, here, I dissociate, I want to get rid of this, I don't want all of this. The whole world seems fake to me. People all seem like they're just actors and all just pretend. There is something wrong. I do not want it. I want to live right in my everyday life and don't want to have such strange perceptions. In reality, it is an expansion of consciousness, and people don't understand that, because then they only pull the negative aspects forward and look at them. But in the big picture, these are the first steps towards expanding consciousness. I put together a few points, which just show the possibilities how the superpower of dissociation with knowing and controlled handling has to offer from the immediate waking state. First, psychologically. Can you create countless forms of therapy for dissociation? And also, from a therapeutic point of view, you can see that your own self is fragmented. And then you can learn that these selves that you have inside do not really communicate with each other, they have to be reconnected, so that greater communication takes place. In addition, also in therapeutic terms, can you collect many repressed and split personalities, parts of yourself again, and reintegrate again? And of course, from a therapeutic point of view, it is also interesting because you can explore the subconsciousness here. Yeah, and from a spiritual point of view, there are, of course, a lot of possibilities what you can achieve with the dissociation. For example, you can achieve all kind of self-knowledge. Or lucid dreaming can be achieved. Spontaneous healing of the physical body from a medical point of view. Or you can also explore and get to know your own personality aspects, your own characters in your own mind. In addition, dissociation provides fairly easy access to alternative realities. You start to perceive alternative realities. You know Shiva too, don't you? Yeah, yeah, I already know 1, 2, 3 points of it. Yeah, just, and also other incarnations. What life you've been in before, what role you played there, what you did there in other lives. Most of the time they come to mind as spontaneous flash. Yeah, right. Then they can suddenly shoot into consciousness. That suddenly you have a memory. Oh my God, I see myself riding an Indian horse there. So such pictures can suddenly shoot into your consciousness. Or other scenes maybe from other lives you had. When exploring alternative realities, all of this has to be considered more meticulously. At first, you notice small, tiny deviations from the normal, everyday reality. Suddenly, a plant appears that has never been there before. Or you are sure that yesterday there was something else at a certain place. And the other day there is something completely different, so you get there step by step. That you learn to perceive these alternative realities, which are only slightly different than the reality you think you know. And of course, dissociation also leads to higher levels of consciousness of all kinds. You can't imagine that. You can also reach states of consciousness which normally, when you enter them and experience it, you immediately forget it when you come back from the state of consciousness to the state of everyday life. Then you usually forget that you have just been in this higher state of consciousness. And through the dissociation you can take the memory with you, because you can fully experience and experience the higher state of consciousness. Paranormal skills can also be developed through dissociation, like clairvoyance, precognition or telepathy. Telekinesis and many other paranormal abilities can be achieved if you are interested. Or like you, Shiva, with remote viewing. You already had a lot of experience by dissociating with your eyes closed. And what can also be achieved through dissociation? Is the consciousness change into the mental body? What the spiritually interested people regard as out of the body experience or astral body. This can also be achieved through dissociation, namely to consciously change into this astral body. And if you have trained yourself a little bit in dissociation, you can achieve that within 3 minutes. Do not think within 3 minutes. Sag, you are immediately in the astral body. And you can fly wherever you want to go. And of course, as I said, the dissociation also aids in reactivating the pineal gland strongly. Exactly. With me it always pounds. It always pounds with you. Yeah. And of course, the dissociation can also cause time distortions. Have you ever experienced a few? Yeah. Yeah, I did. Time distortions, that is, time can be perceived more slowly, be noticed more quickly. You suddenly feel like you skipped half an hour, or certain minutes can then become hours. So, of course, all such options are also available. Time dilation, yeah. And who, of course, will eventually become a master in dissociation, then you really have to be a master, then you can reach more things than this. For example, you can change your reality totally. Here, like in the series The OA, yeah, we have made a movie review to the series. A great series, we can recommend it to everyone. Best series of all times. Yeah, in any case, you must watch it. And this is also possible by using the dissociation, what is also demonstrated in the series. Additionally, it is about alternative realities. And even to change consciously into these alternative realities and to stay there. Not falling back into the normal everyday reality. This means, what did you say? Yeah, we already have talked about dissociation and about changing realities. And then appeared a lot of questions. What will happen with my body? Will my body be dead? Then when I change, you already have experienced such a change of reality. Maybe you like to explain or to answer the question. No, you are not dead then. You just changed the reality. And what happens with the body here? The body keeps alive. Is there anybody in it? Yeah. I think the one from the other reality, or? Not necessary, because any human has two selves. First, a known ego, and second, I would say, an inner ego.
Und zwar der, der in einer anderen Realität war, wahrscheinlich, oder?
Nee, nicht unbedingt.
And this inner ego changed the reality. This inner ego is more our true self than the ego. That is, the inner ego changed the reality. And the outer ego will remain. It remains always. And this ego exists in every self, in every existing alternative reality. Yeah, so the body don't fall to ground suddenly. Or what can happen if you change your reality? That means, will you have other friends there? Yeah. You will have another life there.
Genau, also der Körper hier fällt nicht einfach um. Was?
But you don't have to worry now, because if you are so far with dissociation that this could be happening, how long you have to train dissociation? Maybe 100 million years or so? I think this cannot happen just by accident. That we try to calm down the people, because they may think at first the worst and the world dooms, but it isn't that dramatically. So you have to dissociate, clear dissociation, 15 minutes in a row, no one fought. And before you think, dear God, what if I really would do it? At first, just try to do one single minute. After this, we will talk further about this. So please, not thousands questions about what if I achieve 15 minutes. If you achieve 15 minutes, then you have gained so many insights and understandings and experienced so many altered states that you can easily put away the 15 minutes. And by then, you have had so many questions answered. Yeah, so don't worry about that. Get there first. That's the way it is. You have to do that first. First reach this 1 minute. Then you have really reached a milestone. True, and here about these superpowers, so what can I say about it? What was with me when I started dissociating was that I suddenly resigned. And actually, as you described, have perceived the personality parts, but from the outside perspective. They have something like, I know, who knows Big Bang Theory, the series? Sheldon has the advice of the Sheldons, and the original Sheldon sits at the front, and all the other Sheldons sit around it. The cool Sheldon, the neurotic Sheldon, and so you can actually imagine the personality. The inner ego is the Sheldon sitting at the very front of the council. I assume that you can compare that. Yeah, great. And the outer ego is all the personality parts that sit around. It, maybe someone knows. And at least, as an inner Sheldon, I could then perceive all the outer Sheldons and how they tried to discuss with each other. So that was the first thing I noticed. You get a little bit more into the observer and then suddenly sees the aspects of yourself, so to speak. I agree. I can say about the alternative realities. I went for a walk recently and suddenly I saw an alternative self walking in front of me and one was walking behind me. And then I tried to perceive and connect with them. I imagine that it worked. Who knows? In any case, you can suddenly see alternative reality in front of you. Exactly. Or you see alternative reality in the monitor in front of you. It happened to me already. Exactly. That's the way it is. But, as I said, so, to finally change an alternative reality, you have to dissociate for 15 minutes straight.
Das ist auch gar nicht so toll,
and that's not as great as you might imagine, because there may be other friends. a completely different relationship, or maybe you have children there or no children, or family or no family, or other opportunities that are there can openly do that here. Maybe you could have another job or something. There are countless possibilities that are suddenly changed, and that change would stay that way. But please, don't wet your pants right away. As I said, that's what happened. It takes a very, very long process of practicing. And by time you are there, you have gathered so much knowledge and insights that you can easily handle it. So it is. And you don't have to strive for that now. Many are also quite happy with their lives the way they have designed it. So people, don't overdo it. And besides, if you don't want to change reality, you are not forced to do that. Even if you dissociate for 15 minutes, I assume.
Okay.
I won't say anything now. Okay. Because who dissociates 15 minutes at a time? That is actually an agreement. But as I said, you get that first, maybe sometime in years or so.
Und für die Leute, die unter euch,
and for the people of you who are more materially oriented, they might say, yeah, spirituality, yeah, exciting topic, I like to talk about it, but I don't want to do anything for it now. My bank account is important to me, my company is more important to me or something. They can also use the dissociation. By making a dissociation, but here too, if you start this minute, that is, it's about to reach the minute of fully dissociating, so you can sit down and say a sentence three times, a wish or how you want something, maybe in a relationship or in a professional life or the like. You mean create a reality? Right, how we create a reality. That you say the sentence three times and then you try to dissociate this minute. Something like, I want to be a farmer now, I want to be a farmer now, I want to be a farmer now. And then you start to dissociate. Yeah, so always formulate affirmative and present, of course. Oh, okay then, I am a farmer. Okay, I am a farmer, okay, everything good. Something like that. And the more specific the wish, of course, the better. For example, if you want more money or something, or if someone somehow wants a new job or something, imagine what job you would like to have, and then say that three times, dissociate for a minute. If you shouldn't make this minute, start over, say three more times and dissociate for a minute. And do not think that material and spiritual are mutually exclusive. Definitely not. So you can do more with a clear conscience. Wish for money without feeling spiritually bad. Yeah, that's right. Everyone has to live. And no, that is not mutually exclusive. To live well and still be wise and spiritual, the higher self doesn't judge. Remember, you love that. You love whatever you are, poor or rich. Yeah, I think we have been talking about the dissociation for 47 minutes now. Wow! And then, at the end, I would like to add what is really, really important. That you don't compare dissociation with meditation or trance. Because these are completely different emotional states and frequency states. It doesn't even feel a bit the same. No chance. So these are completely different stories, because you always ask, yeah, but you don't think when meditating either. As I said, the feelings is very, very different, and you are also in a completely different frequency. And another thing, so we will soon create an online dissociation workshop if someone's interested. Because with dissociation you can really achieve anything, and so you're cordially invited to participate in it too. And this really, really cool way to learn. I think dissociation is the best technique out there. Ever, ever, ever. And everything can be reached with this. Even out-of-body experiences. Yeah, out-of-body experience, lucid dreaming, everything. Even time travel should actually be possible. I haven't
Hab's nicht
tried it yet, but
probiert,
I think you have to practice
aber
especially for
ich
that.
denke mal, da muss man ganz speziell dafür üben, dann kann man das auch hinbekommen. Also die
Then you can do that
Dissoziation
too. So
ermöglicht einem
dissociation is really
alles,
does
sowohl im
everything.
materiellen Sinne als auch im
Both in the material
spirituellen.
sense and in the spiritual.
Genau.
And
Jetzt
now our
folgt unser
farewell follows.
Abschiedsgruß.
Yeah, that was our big tour with the exciting topic dissociation. We hope you enjoy it. Yeah, and of course we hope that you enjoyed the little tour through Battle Abbey. And yeah, we hope you learned a little bit about dissociation. We would be very happy to write a few comments below. How is your development in your dissociation training? Maybe you have already had a few experiences. You can feel free to go down there in the report comments. I agree. And give us a like. Yes, then thanks for watching and see you next time. Ciao!
Bis zum nächsten Mal.